Minimalize and declutter go hand in hand. Minimalizing or the live more by owning less lifestyle is becoming very popular over the last years. There is a lot of information available on this subject, but to be honest, I had a hard time finding simple solutions. Things like how to get started and after that expand, simplify, and declutter even more. You may have noticed that I write about minimalizing and declutter in the same sentence. After reading a ton of articles and listening to podcasts and watching videos, it is my opinion that these two are connected to each other and you cannot do one without the other. I have noticed that getting up in the morning in a decluttered house makes my mind more organized for the day and I am able to focus more on my day ahead. A decluttered house is a place for a decluttered mind. I think that starting with these tips I found is the easiest way. Tip 1. Remove 10 things you do not wear anymore. This is very easy, at least it was for me. Go through your closet and have a look at all your pants, shorts, t-shirts, and even underwear. Pick 10 pieces and toss them in a bag or box. You see how much room that made in that drawer or closet already. You can maybe even take out more than the first 10 pieces. Tip 2. End of the day, take care of the clothes you wore that day. This one might be simple and a normal routine for many of you, but for me it was not. Dirty clothes go straight in the laundry basket or whatever you use. Clean clothes go back in the hanging closet or folded in the drawer. Tip 3. Clean up your kitchen countertop. Have you noticed that your coffee maker, toaster, can opener, and all kind of other small appliances you use are on the countertop and make it look messy? Put them out of sight every time you have used them or at least every night and see how that looks. Waking up in the morning and walking into a kitchen that is not cluttered will give you a better start of the day. Tip 4. Put dishes in the dishwasher or hand wash them right away. This is actually part of tip 3, but I wanted to address it separately. Dirty dishes in the sink or on the countertop can look cluttered. Put them in the dishwasher or hand wash them right after breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Don't forget the late dish you used for your late night snack. Tip 5. For this tip, I want you to have a look at your mail routine. We all get them unwanted advertisement magazine and folders. We don't need them, but I used to go through them every time. Now I just toss all the mail I did not ask for right in the recycle bin and don't even look at them. The mail gets opened right away and placed where it needs to be placed, and that is not on the kitchen table anymore like I used to do. File or store it right away and do not let it sit around. These 5 tips and ideas can help you get started with the decluttering of your house. Now it is time to take a look at minimalizing. Like I said, in my opinion, decluttering is part of minimalizing and I think they go hand in hand. What do we have to look at to become a minimalist is list of thing, and I can see that they cannot be achieved all at the same time, but try to do as many as you can. Tips I found that contain the things we have to look at mainly have the following in them. What you possess. Many things we have do not give us any value. They just cost money to buy and sit there. Did you or do you really need that latest big screen TV and the latest gadgets, or do you just do what all the advertisement tells us to buy? All these possessions can keep us away from the things that are really important in our lives. Things like spending more time with our loved ones and from living the life we like to live. Set yourself goals to reduce your goals. I know that does not sound right, but this is what I mean with that. We all have to reduce the goals we have in our life and just focus on the ones that are important to use. These goals will help us to achieve what we are trying to do. Minimalize and declutter. That promotion you are working on to make more money, you don't need that because you decided that you're going to get rid of all the possessions you don't need. Goals you could set. Reduce your debt. Eat healthier food. Fill your mind with positive thoughts. Use positive words. Minimize your commitments. These are just a few goals that can help you with living a simpler but more fulfilling life. Get rid of unnecessary things and simplify your life by focusing on important things. Spend more time with your family by getting rid of routines you had and that take up a lot of time. Stop spending time on things that not have any value for you. Negative thoughts and words are one of the most dangerous things that can bring you down. Keep your thoughts and words positive. You can read my article about the use of positive words in your daily life here. Relationships. We need relationships with other people, but they should bring value to our lives and not be distracting us. Turn off your phone and stop looking at Facebook updates all the time. Set a time for that and then stop using it. TV time. Have you noticed how many hours you spend watching movies or playing video games? These things can have a big impact on your life. I used to be a news junkie and watch the news all day long if I could. Now I watch it once a day and sometimes not even that. This freed up a lot of time and I got rid of a lot of negativity since the negative news did that to me. Don't multitask. Personally, I do not believe that multitasking exists or is possible. You can do one thing for the full 100% or two things less than 100% is my opinion. Multitasking is proven to cause more stress and even lowers productivity. Do one thing at the time and do it right. I know that I have been rambling a little in this article and some of it might not make sense to you. Sometimes I just type and do not think too much. My style is to write as if you were sitting on the couch in my living room and we had a conversation. Let me know how you have done decluttering and minimalizing in your life in the comment section below.